Stop it. Stop it.
You just look so good from this angle.
Just fix the sink.
Just do what?
Fix the sink.
Okay, I will.
When?
Right now.
Hi.
Oh.
Hi.
Am I interrupting?
No.
Yes?
No. What's going on?
Ken's on his way over here to pick me up for work.
Here?
The mystery dentist is coming to Staten Island.
Angela, I've got to talk to you.
Okay. Just a minute. Step into my office.
Step into my office. I'll fix the sink.
What's the matter?
Oh, fell asleep at Ken's last night and I didn't get home until 2 in the morning.
Ooh. Was Daddy up?
No, but Mama was. I'd rather face his wrath than her guilt trip any day.
Oh, come on, Teresa, you're a grown woman.
Sleeping with her married boss and living at home with 2 devout Catholics.
Yeah. Well, his divorce will be final soon, right?
Not soon enough.
We're not anxious or anything, are we?
Who's this? That's not him, is it? Hey, go on, get out of here.
Shh. I gotta go. So when do we get to meet Dr. Dashing?
Soon.
How soon?
Not you.
Yeah, but Teresa, look, you just be careful here, okay? Married man, he's a dentist. You don't know where he's been sticking his drill.
Oh, yeah.
About Ken's divorce?
I wouldn't. It's one thing he's not Catholic, but I don't think Ma could handle a divorce. Maybe later.
Well, how much later?
10, 20, 30 years, maybe. What? Oh, okay.
And there's the child.
A what? She's a little girl. She's 4.
Come on. What are you doing? Let's go.
You don't want to
what?
Tell me?
What's up?
No, okay,
tell
well
me.
Then, nothing.
Tell me.
Nothing. Oh, nothing.
Come on, I'm standing in the middle of an Italian soap opera. I'm missing episodes. Come on.
Sorry.
Honey, make sure your father looks nice, okay?
Come here. Let me
do this. Do I call him Dr. Taylor or Ken?
Well, it depends on if you want him to fix your teeth or not. So when's the last time you wore a tie?
At your wedding. That was a nice wedding.
Should have been for the price.
Hey, we're still married. As time goes on, we become a better investment. Whoa! Boy, do you look pretty. Look at you.
Francis, look at this.
Oh, Teresa, our little girl, Joe. Oh, honey. Don't wrinkle her.
I'm not wrinkling.
No, he's not.
It's a dress.
It's not the dress. She happens to be a knockout.
Dress helps.
Well, Lisa, Ma, you grew up nice, just like Mama.
Hey, what am I, chub liver?
Hey, maybe you should get a dress like this.
You better not.
How much?
Never mind. It was worth it.
What's this?
It's a Cadillac.
Oh, number one sister.
Mm-hmm. Oh. I love you.
I love you, too. It's for good luck.
Thank you.
Jared, honey, are you ever going to get dressed?
I'm already dressed.
Oh, you are? Well, maybe you should try again, huh?
I think Jerry looks very nice.
I think Jerry should wear his tie.
Guys, come on. Would you keep it down? Keep it down here. Come on.
Oh, it's Ken. It's Ken.
Shampoo.
Quiet. I'll get it.
Wait a minute.
Oh,
here
I never
enjoy
that.
What?
Honey, did you turn down the oven?
The oven never made me an offer.
Comedian.
Yes, I did. I did. Come on.
Mr. Silvano.
Yes.
Hi, I'm Ken Taylor.
Joe Silvano. I heard a lot about you.
Uh-oh. I better leave.
No. Good stuff. Please, come in. Oh, that's nice.
Thank you.
What about Maze over the Maggio?
No, what is this?
Brooklyn Dodgers.
Oh, Elmo.
I remember when Andrew hit 350. You remember that?
Yeah, we all remember that.
Great average.
You should have stuck with it.
Yeah, well, actually, that was in softball. Slow pitch.
Well, it's still real good.
Well, we all thought so.
Jared was a pitcher.
Baseball, high school.
All right.
Until I threw out my arm.
Yeah, but you were good, hon. What, you were in your senior year, you were 10-3, right?
11-2, but no one's counting.
Who's counting, huh?
11-2 is terrific. 11-2 is fantastic.
How about you, Ken? Did you play?
Yeah, I played center field for Indiana University, where I led the league in swallowing dirt while sliding in the second base.
Be modest. Ken's a sensational athlete.
Yeah, was.
He could do push-ups for hours.
God. Where?
Yeah, let me fill that up. Thank
you. You're terrible. Oh, Ken, never mind. It's not important. Just leave it.
That's no problem. Where I grew up, cleanliness was right next to godliness.
You could eat off this man's floors.
Well, you could, except I don't know how to cook.
Ken, would you like a little more pasta, chicken, sausage, something?
No, thank you. I'm full. Everything was terrific. It was a wonderful meal. Thank you.
It's our pleasure, Ken.
Joe, I'd planned on having a talk with you tonight, alone, to ask you something very important, man to man. But I've changed my mind. I've decided to ask you all as a family. Teresa and I are very much in love. And I want to ask you all for her hand in marriage.
We're honored to have his family. Buona fortuna.
A salute.
A salute. A salute.
We'll be hearing that all
day. No, no. Viene, viene.
Hay una fame? Vieni. Vieni, per conoscere il dottore Taylor.
Ah, please, Ken.
Sì. Voglio dire che...
Questo è il mio fin d'esatto. E un dentista.
It's a great honor to meet you, sir.
Americano.
He doesn't speak English. Sì, dice che onorato di conoscerti.
Ah, yes, malocchio, la.
Papa?
Dana malocchio. Dana malocchio, la.
No, no.
No, no, Dana malocchio, la. Papa!
Papa!
Papa! Papa!
I'm sorry. You all right?
Sure, I'm fine.
I'm very sorry.
No, don't.
He's an old man. He's.
I didn't mean it.
You all right?
Yeah, I'm fine. It's okay. Thanks again. Bye. Okay. I think I ate way too much. Hope I didn't embarrass you.
No.
They're terrific people.
Sorry about Grandpa.
Don't worry about it. It's okay. Do you think your sister likes me?
Sure she does. Why?
She just seemed...
Oh, she's just checking you out because you're so gorgeous.
I can't wait to see you tonight.
8 o'clock?
Sharp.
As a tack?
Yes.
Daddy, did you like the picture I did for you today?
Oh, I love that picture. You know what I'm gonna do?
What?
I'm gonna hang up my office first thing in the morning.
You are?
Mm-hmm.
Are you gonna come back and live with us?
Angel, we'll just see about that, okay?
Okay.
Good night, darling.
Good night.
I love you.
Love you.
Just tell me the truth.
I still love you.
Why don't you have it printed on your wedding invitations? I still love my ex-wife.
I feel so empty without you. I need you so much.
Hello?
Teresa, I'm so sorry. I took Astrid out for an ice cream after the movie and I lost track of the time. I just completely lost track of the time.
It's kind of late to be calling.
When we got back to the house, I told Marilyn you and I were getting married and she flipped out. I had to give her a sedative.
Ken, I'm tired.
Darling, forgive me. This will never happen again. I'm sorry. I love you.
We'll talk about it tomorrow. Good night.
Okay, gentlemen, you like hockey skating? Give it up for Miss Pretty Bear!
Hi, kid. How's it going?
Oh.
Here you are, ma'am.
Thank you.
Oh, boy, look at that arrangement. Is that for Teresa?
No, Ma, it's for you.
For me? Oh, you're kidding. I don't have my glasses on. To Francis, with thanks for bringing such a beautiful daughter into the world, with love from your future son-in-law. He is so perfect.
Yeah, maybe a little too perfect.
What is that supposed to mean?
I don't know. It seems like he's rehearsed, like he's watching himself.
No, he's just different from what you're used to. He's a college boy. He's a dentist.
Yeah, maybe you're right.
Oh, let's take it into the dining room. Wait till Teresa sees it. Oh, I never saw anything so beautiful in my life.
Or so heavy.
Would you mind getting Mrs. Finch's upper impressions? Mrs. Finch, excuse me, I have to go check on something.
There's some sort of problem?
No problem. You just relax. Saying friends for life, no more strife.
We have a saying too: don't jerk around an Italian girl or you get your head ripped off.
Hey, I love you,
Ken. Stop. Oh,
yes.
Stop it.
Please, God. Forgive me, Teresa. Forgive me, please.
We can talk about this later.
Teresa.
Ken, we're at work.
It doesn't matter. I don't care. I need you. I need you so much.
Thank you.
found your family yet?
They'll be here.
Well, maybe they got lost.
God, I hope not. Turn around.
Why? What? What?
Nothing. You just look so beautiful, that's all.
Thanks. So do you. Well.
I guess this makes us family.
Yeah.
Do I get a kiss?
I'm gonna go find Jer.
Wait a minute.
Here they are.
Come meet my family. Hi, Mom.
Hello, sir.
Where you been?
I'm not sure. Too many people in this state. They're like sardines. I feel like a sardine.
Hi, son. Congratulations.
Thanks, Dad. Where's Tom?
Well, your brother couldn't make it.
He's supposed to be my best man. What happened?
Well, you know Tom.
Don't tell me the Taylors.
All the way from Indiana.
Hey, we're just about giving you up to lost. It's the Jersey Highways.
Oh, forget it. If you weren't born here, you can't find the place.
Joe Silvano, Teresa's dad.
Zach Taylor.
And I'm Frances, proud mom.
Jean Taylor.
Hi.
In case you haven't guessed, this is our other daughter, Angela.
Hi. And this is our son, Andrew, Mr. and Mrs. Taylor.
Nice to meet you.
So let's get married, huh?
Right.
Let's go.
Okay. Oh, Zach. This much kissing at Italian weddings?
I've never seen anything like this.
Did you cry? What do you think?
Yeah, me too.
Look.
Oh my God, you wore it.
It did bring me good luck.
Yeah. Anya, earrings. Grandma's earrings.
I know. Mama gave them to me last night.
They're perfect, Anya.
Something old.
Oh!
Tell me I'll be this happy forever.
You'll be this happy forever.
Why did I dance with my wife?
Sorry.
I got a surprise for you. For all we know.
I sure hope this marriage works out better than the other two.
Aeromexico Flight 31 from Acapulco now arriving at Gate B. Arriving passenger
Oh, maybe they missed the plane.
Teresa would have called.
Well, maybe they got bumped, you know, overbooking.
Let's call.
Okay, thanks a lot. They never called his office. You know, They're having such a good time, they just decided to stay over.
Why didn't they call?
Pa, I don't know. They're on their honeymoon.
I'm gonna call a hotel.
Thank you very much. Let's go, honey.
Las Olas Hotel? Yes. One moment, please. Es el papá de la señora Taylor.
Sister's in the hospital. She's been beaten up. She almost died. They say Ken did it.
Okay, we're here. The police say Ken did this to you. Did he do this to you?
No, no. Ken loves me.
It's okay now. We're here to take care of you, okay?
Yeah.
We're gonna take care of you. God.
Hi. Glad you're here. Darling, did you get any sleep? What are you doing here? Bringing flowers to my wife.
You're big on flowers, aren't you?
I thought you were in jail.
He didn't do it.
It's all right, honey.
I went to sleep in my hotel and I woke up in the hospital. Daddy, he's my husband. He wouldn't do this.
Well, who did this to you then?
The ones who broke in and robbed us. Apparently she blacked out when they started beating her. I think it's probably a blessing.
The police said there were no robbers. The
police don't know or care what happened. They just want to collect bribe money. 4 days, I was locked in that rat hole. Hell, I didn't know she was alive. Darling, will you be okay for just a minute?
Yeah.
Because I need to talk to Joe and Angela.
Okay.
Be right back.
I'm gonna be right outside that door, okay?
Okay.
Be right back.
This whole thing is a cover-up. You think a thing like this helps the tourist trade? They don't want this to get out.
Ken, the police...
It's bribery. It cost me $500 to get out of jail. I was lucky I had that much in the hotel safe because those goons sure took everything else we had.
What are you talking about?
We're asleep, okay? I hear glass shattering. I open my eyes. There's 3-4 guys by the bed with ski masks on. One of them clobbers me. Something heavy, a lamp, I don't know. When I come to, looks like a bomb has hit. Our suitcases have been slashed, everything. I look around for Teresa and she's not there. She's lying on the floor in a pool of blood. And I can't find her pulse. I call the front desk. I call the cops. It wasn't until later that I realized that we had been robbed. They took everything. Camera, watches, jewelry, everything. And Angeles, the God's truth.
If it is, then I'm sorry. But if it's not...
Angela, we're family.
I swear to God, I'll make you pay for this. You understand? Mommy home?
Hello?
Is this Marilyn Taylor?
It is.
I'm Angela Cimarelli. I'm Teresa Taylor's sister.
What can I do for you?
Well, I need you to tell me something.
Look, I was just on my way out, Miss Cimarelli.
Did Ken ever hit you?
Hello?
What's happened?
My sister, Teresa, she got beat up on her honeymoon.
And she doesn't remember anything about it, so I was wondering if you could...
Ken never beat me.
I'm sorry. I'm sorry to have bothered you.
Is she all right?
So what I can't understand is how Ken didn't get hurt, and you...
He was lucky.
Everybody thinks Ken did it.
He couldn't have done it. Angela, he's my husband. He loves me.
Can't you just make yourself remember?
How would you like it if I kept telling you Jerry beat you up?
Okay. I'll shut up. Sorry. She's just not the same, Daddy. She used to talk to me. She doesn't even talk to me anymore.
Hi.
Don't you knock?
Oh, sorry.
The boys are watching the Mets.
All right.
You hungry?
No, thanks. I haven't been eating. My stomach's in knots.
Yeah, well, Teresa can't eat too much either. It's kind of hard to get decent food down those intravenous tubes.
Angela, if you want to believe I did it, you go right ahead. There's nothing I can do. Doesn't anybody believe Teresa?
Would you like a beer, Ken?
No, it's not good to drink during emotional stress. You should take it easy too, Joe.
Did I ask you about my health? I don't remember asking you about my health.
Take it easy.
All right, look. Teresa's coming home from the hospital tomorrow. For her sake. Let's be together as a family.
Thank you.
me. Ken, here's the codeine you wanted for Mrs. Taylor.
Thanks, Patricia. By the way, you've been doing a sensational job.
Thank you.
I want to see about getting you a raise.
That would be great.
Ken, may we speak to you for just a moment?
Sure.
Would you excuse us, Patricia?
What's up? Oh, I know what this is about. I can explain everything.
Ken, there's over $5,000 missing here.
I don't know. It's not missing. You see, I had to dip into the profit sharing for my honeymoon. I didn't think anybody would mind.
We don't just dip into the profit sharing.
Hey, I'm sorry I had you worried. You know I'm good for it.
Ken, we'd just like you to pack your stuff and go.
Is this a joke? Hey, a guy doesn't get married every day. It was my honeymoon. You're serious. I'm fired.
Put it that way if you want.
Fine.
Doing home?
I'm going out on my own.
Why?
I'm starting my own practice. Isn't that great? My dad's gonna loan me the money.
Oh, that's wonderful.
Yeah. How's the pain? You want some more codeine?
No, no more codeine.
So, you can come back to work for me now. You can even get your brother Andrew a job. It'll be a family business.
Yeah, it'll be a while for me, though.
I thought you were feeling better.
Oh, I'll probably start feeling nauseated mornings.
Are you...
Yeah.
You really want it? You really want to have it?
Yes, of course. I want to have this baby, don't you?
Sure, it's just so soon after Acapulco, you know? I mean, that's, I don't want you getting tired.
I want to get tired. Aren't you happy?
Of course I am.
Really?
Ooh. I'm sorry, I don't want to hurt you. What's for supper?
You're taking me out to celebrate. Are you really happy?
Yeah, I said I was.
Let's go tell Angie and Jerry.
Yeah.
Come on.
Yeah. That's a great idea. Here. Come on!
No.
Fine. I'll celebrate by myself.
myself.
When the contraction begins, take a big, deep, cleansing breath. Then, as the contraction continues, breathe through the mouth quickly. When it's all over, take a big, deep, cleansing breath. Good. Okay, let's do it again.
Come on, relax. Is everything okay?
Yeah, sure. Why? Relax.
You just seem so tense.
No, everything's fine. Teresa, come on, talk to me,
please.
Marriage is such a big adjustment.
Yeah, tell me about it.
You know, Ken is...
What?
Different than I expected. I don't know.
What?
Well, I mean, you know, don't get me wrong. Things are good. I mean, he loves me and... But,
What?
Well, it's like things like... He gets real annoyed if I'm not home exactly when I say...
Did anything to you?
No. I just wish... I wish he'd get more excited about the baby.
Oh, sweetheart, he will. As soon as that baby's born and you're holding it in your arms, he's gonna be so excited.
Teresa, how you doing?
Good.
You breathing?
Yep.
Good.
You are so gorgeous. Yes, you are, little Andrew. You look just like your mama. Yes, you do.
Look at all that hair.
Oh, oh my God, you're so precious. So what did Andy think when you named the baby after him?
Oh, he acted cool.
Yeah.
But I think he was pretty honored.
What'd Ken say?
I told him we'd name the next one after his brother.
Sweetie. So how are things between you and Ken?
Well, it's been... He's been working so hard with the new practice. I mean, he spent no time with the baby.
Now, we have vitamin A in the carrots, protein in the soup. Now, I'll take Andrew and give him a nice sponge bath while you two visit.
Be careful of his head.
I've raised children. Come on, Andrew. We'll go take a nice warm bath.
What is all this stuff?
Pamphlets on the Protestant faith. Jean wants him to be baptized Protestant.
Oh, well, what would Mama say?
We'll work something out. Angela. You never know what love is until you have a baby. What? I know that look. What?
Nothing.
Tell me.
Yeah.
If you don't, I'll tickle you.
No, no. Okay. Andrew's gonna have a cousin.
Ah! Oh, you're kidding. It's wonderful. When?
December.
Ah. Oh, what a great Christmas it's gonna
be. I know, two more stockings for the mantle.
Ooh. Hey, will you be Andrew's godmother?
Of course I will. You're gonna be my little baby's godmother.
Thank you.
I'm so hot just thinking about you. I've been lying here.
What are you doing?
Nothing. I had a nightmare. I was just getting some milk.
I'll get it for you. Teresa, would you give me a steak sauce, please?
Sure. Have you heard from the insurance people about that stuff that we had that was lost in Mexico?
No. Why?
I'm just curious. I really miss those earrings my grandma gave me.
Yeah, well, once things disappear down there, you might as well forget about it.
Right.
Anytime, honey. Come on. Oh, wait, I better get that. Goodbye, darling.
You want to talk about it?
It's nothing.
You sure?
Yeah.
Come on, Teresa, don't do this to me.
I'm late.
Call me later. What is it, Ken?
I can't talk.
What has he done?
Later. We'll talk later.
No, okay, fine. I'm just going to come with you.
No, it'll be all right. Look, I'm late. I got to go. The baby's crying. Ken is going to be angry.
Teresa, please.
Will you just back off?
Fine, okay. I'll call you tonight.
Fine. Ken?
Go
Put your head down. Come on. Go sleepy. Go sleepy.
Bye-bye.
Good. Go down. Put your head down. Good boy. Good night. Love you.
Where you been?
My sister.
Why?
I haven't seen her in a while. She's my sister. Do I need a reason? Teresa hasn't picked me up yet. I don't know where she is.
Have a good time.
Okay,
Supposed to be here by 9. Hello?
Ma, hi. Have you seen Teresa?
No. Don't you two have that christening to go to?
She was supposed to pick me up, but I don't know, Ma. I don't like this.
Well, what does Ken say?
I called over there. There was no answer. You know, I'm gonna go over there, okay?
All right. Let me know. Call me.
I will.
All right, bye.
Hello.
Hello, Angela.
Ken, where's Teresa?
Angela, please be calm. I want you to listen to me.
All right, I'm listening.
Your sister, it's very difficult to say. Your sister has a drug problem.
What are you talking about?
Look, you know she needed codeine.
Yeah, for her teeth.
Well, I'm afraid that was just the beginning of her problems.
No, Ken, you were the beginning of her problems.
Angela, insults aren't gonna help.
Where is she?
She wouldn't tell me, but I think a rehabilitation center.
A rehabilitation center?
Yeah, I dropped
Teresa at the airport.
Wait, you just dropped her off? You didn't go in with her? You didn't... Where's the baby?
With me.
Angela, Teresa's very strong-willed. You know that. She does what she wants.
I had the baby, so I didn't have much choice.
Did she say when she'd be back?
2 or 3 weeks. She'll call when she's settled.
One more thing. Teresa doesn't want Joe and Francis to be, you know, upset about her drug problem, so she said to tell them that we
decided to go to Indiana for a short vacation. I'll be in touch.
Ken. Hon? Honey? Look, hon, I am just telling you what he told me. It makes no more sense to me than it does to you.
Listen, where's the drug clip?
He doesn't know.
What do you mean he doesn't know? He drove her to the Angela. Come on, don't say that.
Look, I just want to get to Mom and Dad's, okay?
What are you going to tell
them? I don't know. But I'm not going to tell them that they went on vacation.
Safe hands now, son.
Oh, you look just like your grandfather.
He sure does. Hi, Pop.
How was your trip?
Tiring.
Yeah. Hey. Want me to get the bags? Where's the trunk key?
Trace has got the only trunk key. All the bags are right here in the back seat.
Son, I had no idea you were dealing with a drug addict.
That's not exactly the kind of thing you write home about.
I'm really sorry.
Good to see you.
You too. Let me take that. Yeah.
Hey. Are you stoned?
Yeah. Want some?
No. You told me you were gonna put that stuff down. You told me.
Why didn't you just bring him over here?
Well, Teresa felt it'd be good for Andrew to be here with my folks. You have your hands full.
Don't tell me how full our hands are, Ken.
Teresa never would have suggested that the baby stay with your parents.
Well, maybe the drugs are affecting her decision-making.
I find that impossible to believe.
Joe, Teresa has a drug problem. She kept it hidden from you because she knows how you feel about drugs.
Even if this was true, which I find hard to believe, I don't understand how you could have just left her at the airport, driven off without any hint of where she intended to go.
You know how your daughter is.
It was a very, very bad error in judgment on your part.
Maybe you're right.
I know I'm right.
Maybe I shouldn't have gone along with her. It was a snap decision, but it's too late to do anything about that now. She'll call. Everything's gonna be okay.
Pop, just hang up. He's lying.
I want her reported missing to the police.
Yeah. When I get back on Wednesday, I'll call him first thing. By then, Trace will have called me, so don't worry.
She's my daughter, and I'm worried.
Well, she's my wife, and I'm not.
You better get worried, pal.
The husband has to file a report on a missing person.
She's not a missing person. That's the whole point. The husband probably killed her.
Any signs of domestic violence?
What is this?
Those were taken when she got back from her honeymoon. Her husband did it.
You know that for a fact?
Everybody knows it.
Your sister said he did this.
No.
Detective, the thing that has confused us from the beginning is that Teresa has repeatedly insisted that Ken didn't do it. Frankly, we think she is the only one who believes it.
Look, please try to understand. I can't initiate a missing person case unless the husband files a report. I can't initiate a murder case unless you have some evidence.
Just talk to Ken. Just talk to him, please. Ask him some questions. Look around. You're the policeman. Maybe you can discover something that I couldn't. Please.
All right. Where can I find Dr. Taylor?
He's coming in from Indiana tomorrow afternoon.
All right. I'll do what I can. I promise.
Thank you.
Okay?
Thank you.
Shepherd, I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside the deep waters. He restoreth. Amen. Yes.
Dr. Taylor?
Yes.
Detective Bob Fossack, do you mind if I ask you a few questions about your wife's disappearance?
No, of course not. Come right in.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Oh, this is a nice house.
Well, thanks. I can't really take any credit for it. My wife's done all the decorating.
May I?
Sure. You know, I've looked all over the house. I can't find anything.
Well, you never know. Sometimes people are so accustomed to their surroundings, they miss the most obvious clues. Wish my house was this neat.
Well, Therese's a great housekeeper.
Do you mind?
No, go right ahead.
Nice. You and your wife ever fight?
No, not really. Huh. I mean, every marriage has its ups and downs. I guess this is one of our downs.
Looks that way.
She's been depressed for quite a while now.
How long?
Weeks, months, really. Work pressures mostly, plus she doesn't get along that well with her family.
No?
Plus, being a new mother, I just think it all became too much of a strain for her.
I can sympathize. Did she have some cash with her?
Well, she's got credit cards, and yeah, she had about $800 in cash. I gave her $200 myself. You know, there was one thing.
What's that?
I didn't think much about it at the time. When I dropped her off at the airport, she kissed the baby goodbye, but she didn't kiss me.
Which airline?
I didn't notice. She said, stop here, and I just let her out.
Must have been under a lot of stress to not notice which airline terminal.
Well, under the circumstances, yes, I was.
I understand Mrs. Silvano has heart problems.
Yeah, that's right. That's why I brought Andrew to my mother. I figured, you know, the strain.
Right. Whose are those?
The two on the right are mine, the other two are Teresa's. Hmm. What?
No, I was just thinking. For someone with as many dental problems as Mrs. Taylor, I'd have thought she'd bring her toothbrushes with her.
She's got plenty of toothbrushes. She's married to a dentist.
Right.
Here's something. Her left earring's missing.
We copy.
This is he.
Please understand, it may not be your daughter at all.
I'm coming with you.
Stay with your mother. Andrew, get your jacket.
I'm coming too.
No, you're not. Look at you.
I said I was going.
Just let her come.
Be okay. I'll go next door.
pay for that.
Mrs. Cimarelli, are you sure you... Is that your daughter?
Yes, this is my daughter.
Hey, that's my sister. Let's get out of here.
Angela?
We should have done something about Acapulco.
I tried.
Not hard enough. I just want to kill him. We should have done something.
No. I know. Come on.
Get you something, Francis. You need to keep your strength. I'm gonna go get you something.
You're a big guy. Yeah, your daddy loves you. You know that, don't you? Yeah, you know that. I'm so sorry about your mama. It's just that she didn't really love you. That's why she left you. But your daddy's boy now. Your daddy's boy now. No one will ever hurt you. And no one will ever take you away.
Son.
I'm afraid we have some bad news. It's about Teresa.
What? What is it?
Well, they found her body. Kenny. She's dead. Ken. The police want you to call them. They need all the help they can get.
Okay.
Son, we love you. Remember that.
Follow your lead, Bobby. He's your guy.
Doc.
Detective Fossick.
Thanks for coming in. This is Investigator Malinowski.
Hello. We know how difficult this must be for you. Have a seat.
Thank you. I'm doing everything I can to help.
I have to read you your rights first.
Why?
Standard procedure. You should know you're a suspect.
What are you talking about?
Ken. Everyone's a suspect at this point. It's nothing personal.
Okay.
You have the right to remain silent.
Doc, would you like a cup of coffee?
Sure.
You have the right to an attorney. If you cannot afford one, one will be appointed for you by
Look,
the...
I know all this. Can't we just get on with it? The important thing is to find out who killed Teresa.
You want to just waive your rights?
Sure. That'll be fine.
Cream?
What?
For your coffee.
Yeah, and double sugar, please.
We'll want to search your house.
Again?
Standard procedure, you know.
Sure, when?
Now.
Okay. I guess you'll need these.
That'd be helpful. Thanks.
This house is very clean.
Yeah.
I wonder if they have a cleaning lady. Nobody cleans this good.
Yeah, I want to talk to her. She does a real good job.
Hey, Frank, come up with anything?
Yeah, nothing in the attic.
Hey, fellas, how's it going? Anything?
No.
All right. Anything checking out?
This could be oil. I'm not sure what this is.
That's one of the cleanest tool benches I ever saw.
I don't know. Maybe we ought to try using luminol.
Yeah, I got a call into Fossack. We're checking on that right now.
We can get something off the truck.
No, you don't have to.
That's it. So, how's the babe?
Kicking like crazy.
What do you got for me?
Tuna. Got your tuna.
I like tuna.
I know. That's what I got it for you.
Hey, Angela. Why are you really here?
Yeah, Masa's the lamp carrying. It's a girl.
She should know, huh?
I want Andrew back from Indiana.
All right, we'll get him. We'll bring him up. We'll bring him back here. Then you have somebody to play with.
You mean that?
Yeah, I mean that.
I failed her once, you know.
You didn't
I don't
kill
want
anybody.
Well, she's dead.
Yeah, she's dead. All right, she's dead. But you did not kill her. You gotta stop doing this to yourself.
I want Andrew here. I don't want the parents of that sicko raising my sister's child.
Get him. I promise we'll get him.
Areas have been sprayed.
Right up the wall here.
Hello, can I help you?
Where's our son, Dr. Taylor?
He's still at the station.
What is that?
It's called luminol. It brings out any trace of blood.
What?
It makes it glow.
I'm sorry. You'll have to leave.
When can we come back?
Well, we should be wrapped up in a few hours. Sorry.
Okay, fellas, pull the shades.
Okay, we got it.
Upstairs. Pull the shades.
He did her upstairs.
Let's go. Let's wrap it up, boys. We're booking the doctor.
Good job, guys. Right up there.
Driven.
Where's Andrew?
Baby, he's in Indiana. You know, right?
We have to get him. We have to get him. I promised my sister. I promised you.
Turn the light out. Zach?
Excuse me?
Yes?
I'm Angela Cimarelli.
Yeah.
Teresa Taylor's sister, she was murdered.
Oh, I'm sorry. Can I help you with something?
Yes, I'd like to see Detective Fossack.
Well, he's conducting an interrogation right now, and it may be a while.
I'll wait.
Want to have a seat?
Doc, did you kill your wife?
No. That doesn't make any sense. I was in love with my wife.
Think about it. Take your time.
There's nothing to think about. You guys are wasting your time. You should be out looking for evidence or something.
You ever seen this earring?
No, never have.
Take a closer look. It's from a matched pair. It was just found in your garage. The other one was on Teresa's body.
Maybe she met somebody at the airport and they took her back to the house and killed her there.
Ken, a stranger wouldn't then transport the body somewhere else.
Dr. Taylor, I think you killed your wife.
Maybe there are circumstances we're not aware of.
What would you do if you came down the stairs and found your wife sexually abusing your 5-month-old boy?
Doc, is that what happened? You saw her sexually abusing the baby?
Came downstairs. When I saw what she was doing, I yelled, "What the hell are you doing?" She looked glassy-eyed, her eyes were red, drug-crazed. She grabbed a dumbbell bar from the floor and she swung it at me. I ducked and grabbed it away. And then I gave it to her.
Did you strike her more than once?
Of course I did. What kind of a question is that?
We just need to obtain the facts.
No more questions. I want a lawyer.
Mrs. Zimmerelli?
He said Teresa was doing what?
He said she was sexually abusing the child.
That lying son of a bitch! Killing her wasn't enough. Now he's going to attack her when she's dead.
Mrs. Zimmerelli, we don't believe him. The truth will come out at the trial. Believe me.
Wait a minute. He's going to be saying this at the trial?
I'm sure it won't hold up.
Do his parents know about this?
Well, they're here now.
They're here?
Yeah.
With the baby?
Mrs. Zimmerelli!
Andrew!
I'm sorry, he just doesn't want to see anybody.
Did you tell him it was us?
He has to. Tell him I said so.
Mrs. Zimmerelli!
Andrew!
Mrs. Zimmerelli, please.
I have a right. That is my sister's baby.
This is not a good time. Please, could you go back in?
Ken, I never heard of a mother doing something like that. Did you?
Well, I just don't see how you could have kept her in the trunk all that time.
Well, I kept her as long as I could because I didn't want to be parted from her. I loved her. Why did you bring him back? He should be in Indiana.
Malinowski. Yeah.
Take Andrew back to Indiana.
Yeah.
Teresa and I both agreed if anything happened to us, we wanted you to raise him.
Uh-huh. Yes. That's right. All right.
That's right, Paul.
please.
Apple slices and cheese?
No, thanks.
Have coffee.
I just want you to know we don't hold you responsible for what your son did.
Cream?
Not for me, thanks.
Fell asleep finally. We'd like to discuss Andrew.
There's nothing to discuss.
What is that supposed to mean?
Well, Andrew is ours. Kenny would like us to have him. We're going to have him.
Excuse me, but this is my dead sister's baby we're talking about. There is something to discuss.
No, there isn't. As soon as we can, we're leaving for Indiana with him. He's our grandson.
Is he any less our grandson because Teresa is dead?
When are you leaving?
Thursday.
Well, I hope you'll let us visit him before you go.
Certainly. Just call first.
You're not normal. Nothing to discuss. Can you believe it?
Ma, at least we know what they're planning.
Let's see what a judge has to say.
Under no condition is Andrew to be taken outside of the boundaries of the states of New York and New Jersey before the murder trial is over. Until then, custody will be shared between the paternal grandparents and Angela and Jerry Cimarelli.
I want to go.
How could you let it happen?
It could have been worse. They could have got custody outright.
At least we can see him 4 days a week.
But you have to see him here. I don't want him here with those people. Bitch Angela's behind this, I know it.
What can we do?
We have the truth on our side. We know who Teresa really was and what she did. Let's use it. Hey, big guy.
Hey. Our biggest problem here is motive.
His motive is he's evil.
You mean crazy? Well, he could claim temporary insanity.
Mr. Chappelle, you're the prosecutor. I'm not trying to tell you how to do your job or anything. But how temporary is driving around the country with my sister in the trunk for 4 days?
Mrs. Cimarelli, I need every bit of information. I don't care how small, that sheds light on this man's history.
Maybe somebody ought to talk to his ex-wife, Marilyn.
We're working on it.
Was Ken ever violent with you?
What do you mean violent?
Did he hit you? Beat you?
No.
Did you know his first wife?
Emily Luttrell. He left her when she was 9 months pregnant. For me. I don't think he's ever seen that child.
Did he ever hurt her that you know of?
Oh, I don't think so. Ken is an extremely gentle man. You should see him with children and animals. He's...
Mrs. Taylor, I'm sensing that you're withholding information. Now, you can either cooperate or we can subpoena you in front of a grand jury.
Kiss goodbye.
Slugger, how you doing?
I give Grandpa a kiss, too.
His clothes are clean. I'd appreciate getting them back clean.
You always do.
Hi, sweetie.
Hi.
I'll see you Wednesday.
Hi, Nicole. Is it cold out here or what?
It's the company.
Hello, sweetie. Boy.
Good to have you back.
Hi. Yeah, Detective was here today. No, I didn't tell him anything. Nothing, I swear. He asked about Emily. No, I wouldn't tell him about that.
That's good. That's very good.
He's been coming. Okay, hold it. Angela, stop pushing. Stop pushing. I can see the head. I can see the baby's head now. All right, let me check the cord. Dad, come here.
What are you going to do? No, wait, don't you dare.
You want a picture.
Okay, Angela, I want you to give me one more gentle push, all right? One more gentle push. Here we go. That's it.
Okay. You did it!
She's perfect.
She is so beautiful.
She is a girl.
Gina, it's a little beautiful.
A girl, baby girl, let me see her.
Guess who you're gonna go meet? Guess who you're gonna see? Your mommy.
And daddy.
There you go.
Hi, sweetheart.
Hi, Gina.
Oh
yeah.
Perfect. Hey, can I have one of those?
Sure.
Thanks. Appreciate it.
Ken Taylor.
Yeah, I know. The doctor.
Dentist.
Yeah. Still make a lot of money, though.
Been lucky. Guess the pay's not so good around here, huh?
Stinks.
Yeah, it must be rough. We all need things.
What do you mean?
We can work something out. Oh, don't misunderstand me. I just mean I could use a friend, that's all.
Maybe.
And this is Gina's room. What do you think? You like it, sweetie? Huh?
Oh, yeah, she likes it. She's just speechless.
Oh, God, I can't believe she's finally here. Isn't she beautiful? Oh, God, she's so beautiful.
She is so beautiful. She looks just like her mother.
Just like Teresa.
Miss Teresa's eyes. Honey, I want to get Andrew back.
What do you mean? We get him this Friday.
No, I want him back now. They've had him all week.
Honey. Honey. You just had a baby. All right, relax. See, Gina? Now that's relax.
She's finally here. We did it. We really did it.
We really did do it. You want to do it again?
Yes?
There's a Miss Marilyn Taylor and her lawyer here to see you.
Get Fosick over here right away.
Did he indicate whether or not he intended to leave Teresa?
He was thinking about it. He said he wanted the baby well started in life and established before he would leave her.
Mrs. Taylor, did Ken Taylor ever hit you?
No. But...
Yes?
He tried to kill me once in 1979. We were living in Connecticut then. I was in bed half asleep. It was chloroform.
Did you press charges in Connecticut against Kenneth Taylor after he attempted to kill you? Why not?
Because I thought he was an essentially caring man. And I thought he deserved a second chance.
Court is now in session. Everyone be seated.
Your Honor, with your permission, I'd like to call a series of witnesses to Dr. Taylor's attempt on the life of his second wife, Marilyn Taylor, in Connecticut.
Charges were never pressed on that matter, so Rule 55 does not permit use of any of that material.
I'm going to have to agree with Mr. Lindsay on this.
Your Honor, several of my witnesses were part of the events in Connecticut.
Mr. Chappelle, I'm not telling you how to try your case. I'm just saying you can't talk about an alleged crime in which no charges were pressed. Any of that evidence from Connecticut is off limits. However, I have reviewed the material concerning the events in Acapulco, which I will allow to be presented if the evidence is clear and convincing.
I've known Teresa all my life. If she was doing cocaine at all, it was because of Ken. She'd do anything for him.
Never. I dated Teresa for about 2 years, and she never used drugs. Never.
She had to use codeine because her teeth and her head hurt so much after the beating she got in Acapulco. But no. No other drugs.
Did you continue to question Teresa about her memory of the events in Acapulco?
Yes. She never remembered anything.
But she told you it wasn't Ken.
She said it wasn't Ken.
I really don't think this is a good idea for Andrew to keep going back and forth between our families.
We're acting according to the law.
I know, but I'm not talking about what's legal. I'm talking about what's right. You know, the psychologist said he was a high-risk child, and
Andrew is going to know the truth about his mother and his father.
The truth? What are you talking about, the truth? What do you mean, your version of the truth? You raised a murderer. That's the truth.
I don't have to listen to this. Come on.
I'll tell you what the truth is, lady. The truth is, we're not giving up our half of the custody, and we're going to be here for our son's trial.
Let's go, Zach.
You people are sick, you know that?
You're the sick ones.
Hey. So how's the trial going?
I'm not sure.
Man, it'd sure be a shame to see a professional man spend the rest of his life in a joint.
Yeah, I'd sure hate to miss seeing my boy grow up. You got kids?
Yeah, a boy 10 and a 7-year-old girl.
Well, then you know how great it is to be a dad, huh?
What, are you kidding me? It's all I've got. That and this crappy job.
Maybe we could help you out a little bit.
How do you mean?
Well, I got some things in my house could be sold for a lot of money. Could help a guy who's doing the best he can make ends meet.
How much do you think this stuff's worth?
$12,000 easy.
What do you need?
Let's wait till the trial's over, see what happens.
Sure.
In lieu of this latest information,
Mr. Chappelle, we've already discussed this. Motion denied.
Getting back to the events in Acapulco, what's the next thing you remember?
I woke up, found her in a pool of blood.
What did you do?
Took her pulse, then I phoned for help. Then apparently I passed out.
So what you're saying, Dr. Taylor, is that you did not beat your wife in Acapulco?
No, sir, I did not.
He did!
We cannot have any outbursts like that in this court. Is that clear?
What's the next thing you remember?
Getting up, going to the shower, washing off.
When you say washing off, why?
There were cuts and blood and glass in my legs.
Now, you said that after the beating in Acapulco, your wife started using drugs.
It's not.
And that led to the alleged abuse of your infant son.
Yes, sir.
Dr. Taylor, please state for the record the sexual abuse you witnessed Teresa doing to your son.
Showing the tape is a cheap tactic, and if it is allowed as evidence, I will move for a mistrial.
The defense has made an issue of the decedent's care and concern as a mother. The jury has every right to view her relationship with the infant, and since the defendant is pleading self-defense, they have every right to see her physical stature.
I'm ruling for Mr. Chappelle.
Come on. Come on. Come on, we have to die.
Your Honor, this tape has no relevance. Once again, I ask for a mistrial.
Motion for mistrial denied.
Put some sort of evil spell over the jurors and just gonna walk away.
Not walking anywhere. It's almost the end now, don't worry.
Kurt.
And have you reached a verdict?
We have, Your Honor.
Will the defendant please rise?
We find the defendant guilty.
Yes.
You've ruined my son. But you're not going to do the same to my grandson. I swear.
We'll have order.
Feeling about this.
From September 1 to June 30 each year, custody of Andrew is to be with Jerry and Angela Cimarelli. From July 1 to August 31, the Taylors will have him, along with an extra week beginning the day after Christmas. The father will be permitted one phone call per week to Andrew. Angela and Jerry are to take the child for a monthly visit to his father in prison.
I am not taking him to any prison.
Shh. No, I thought you said
this is the best we could do. Who can do it? It'll work out.
I can't believe this.
No, this is wrong. You have much more experience than they do with kids.
Well, I'd much rather he'd be brought up in the Midwest in a good Christian home with good old-fashioned values.
Right.
This vast lane is no place to grow up.
Then we'll fight it all the way. When are you taking off?
Sunday. Listen, Ken.
You have your job. I understand. It's okay.
Well, I don't get back.
Listen, it has meant the world to me to have you here this long. Dad, when you go, just put the keys under the front mat. I got a friend coming by for some stuff.
Sure. Anything you say, son.
Hello?
You can't win this thing. You can't keep my son from me.
Stop calling here, damn it! I can't stand it.
Hey.
kids?
My mom's. He called again today. 3 times.
Okay. We're going to change our phone number.
No. Then we have to tell Gene and Zach, and then they tell Ken. I am not taking Andrew to any prison. Okay? The psychologist said we shouldn't even let him talk on the phone.
So we'll just defy a court order, and he'll tell the judge.
Fine. Let him.
Yeah, I can get robbed in here.
Here's that book I borrowed.
Did you like it?
Oh, yeah, I like most of his stuff.
Me too.
Acts like he's related to the Taylors. They have a bigger house, they make more money. Ken's 30-year sentence and the fact that he just tried to break out of jail doesn't even seem to faze him.
Look, we knew if we kept hanging up on Ken, his parents would come after us. Fine, let him. We're the good guys. The good guys win.
Your Honor, we're here to establish that the Cimarellis are not in compliance with the custody order.
Proceed.
No, we have not.
Have you permitted telephone calls from Dr. Taylor to his son?
The psychologist said that if we did
that... Mrs. Cimarelli, I'm losing my patience.
Have you permitted phone calls from Dr.
No.
And are you now trying to evade the 2-month visitation in Indiana?
Your Honor, could I just say something here?
Just answer the question.
Are you trying to evade compliance with the 2-month visitation?
I heard you.
Your Honor, this is preposterous. I demand this visitation be enforced.
Mrs. Cimarelli, I'm going to give you until June 16 to answer this motion. This is contempt of court we're talking about. So when you come back, I want you to be sure to have your T's crossed and your I's dotted, understand? Do you understand?
Yes, sir, Your Honor.
What is that?
That is a letter from Gene to the court.
How did you get it?
The court sent it to a lawyer.
I don't have my glasses, Joe. Read it.
Well, it says that we are all unfit to be near Andrew, and that as soon as she's able to, she's going to tell him the whole truth.
Oh, the truth.
Yes, that Teresa was a bad mother, she was a drug addict, that she was sexually abusing Andrew, and that Ken killed her to stop her from harming him.
They mustn't be allowed near him.
Okay, so what are we going to do?
We're going to get another lawyer.
What?
We are getting a woman this time. We're going to get somebody who can understand what we're going through because maybe she has a couple kids of her own.
Okay, great. We're going to get another lawyer.
Yes.
We're going to pay him with or prefer her with. I'm working double shifts now. We're going to pay him with our good looks.
You find a lawyer, we'll get the money.
Hi, I'm Janice Miller.
Jerry.
Hi, Angela.
Hi. You met my husband, Frank.
Yeah. Thank you for seeing us on such short notice.
No problem. Come on into the office. Well, I'd say you need custody.
Outright, not shared.
See, honey, this is what a lawyer is supposed to do.
I didn't say I was sure you'd get it.
Well, what are the odds?
Not bad. You'd have to go back into court. It could be expensive.
How expensive?
That depends on how long it takes. Look, it's not just the money. With my current caseload, I'm not sure I'd be able to commit myself to what could be an extensive procedure.
Janice, there is a little boy out there whose mother has been murdered. And the man that murdered her is trying to keep that little boy away from us. Please, we need your help.
Do you have all the papers there?
Yeah.
Your Honor, I need more time to prepare my case.
No, I'm sick and tired of this whole business. These people came a long distance to be here. Grandfather, myself, I know what it's like to be separated from your grandchildren. Let's get on with it.
Dr. Hill, you've been a child psychologist for 12 years?
Correct.
Would you please tell me what you think of this letter sent from Jean Taylor to the court?
What letter is this?
It's in the record, Your Honor.
I never saw this. Why not?
It was written to Judge Langdon and forwarded to my client.
Continue.
What state of mind does that letter reflect to you, Doctor?
Well, it shows that Ms. Taylor harbors extreme hostility toward the Cimarellis and that she intends to convey destructive information to Andrew about his birth mother.
What would the effect of that be?
It would destroy Andrew's self-image.
You're against visitations in prison, right?
Yes.
My conviction's on appeal. Won't it be easier for my son if he continues to visit me in prison rather than being reintroduced to me when I get out?
He's so arrogant. How can he represent himself?
It might make that somewhat easier, but on the other hand, if you lose, it might be very hard on him. So since my father left us when I was 4, I think I know what Andrew's going through in a way.
What was your relationship with Andrew?
I consider myself to be his father. I love him very much. When we got custody of him, I think I loved him because I felt sorry for him. But as the time has passed, I love him because I love him like I love my daughter. He's my son.
Your Honor, my parents were supposed to have custody as of July 1st. I assume that in the interim, my son Andrew will go with them.
Well, you have assumed incorrectly. This hearing is going to be completed and everything will be held in abeyance until it is. I want the attorneys to approach the bench. The attorneys, not you.
I'll do my best.
Look, I've got a full calendar here. I want this settled. I thought we'd be through by now, but obviously we aren't.
Your Honor, here's what we're prepared to do. I've talked to the father of the child. He's willing to give up visitation rights.
I don't know what happened, but all of a sudden the Taylors became almost cooperative.
From August 1st until August 16th, the Taylors will have him in Indiana. On Saturday, August 9th, Angela will visit Andrew in the Taylor residence for 2 hours. And for an hour every day after that for the remainder of the second week. Under no circumstances will there be any contact with Kenneth Taylor. Do you have anything to say?
Not at this time.
Then this case is closed.
All in all, I think we got the best deal possible.
Ken, how you doing?
Thanks for coming all the way here to see me, Ray.
Kenny, I'll do anything I can for your family.
Appreciate it. Ray has agreed to represent you.
Well, that's great. Yeah, we need the best lawyer in Marion.
Well, I'm seeing Judge Shipp first thing in the morning.
Judge Shipp is a good man, yeah.
He's a fair man.
Yeah. Okay, Ray. This is what we gotta do.
What's this about a pending custody proceeding in New Jersey?
Oh, really nothing. There's an aunt and uncle that's trying to get the kids insurance money. You know how Easterners can be.
Well, it's awful. Losing a mother at such a young age. We've adopted, you know.
Yes, sir, I know.
I hope this will help.
I believe it will, sir. Thank you.
No, anyway. Jean, hi, it's Angela. Look, we're on our way. I just need some directions, that's all. What? What are you talking about? Jerry!
What is it?
They adopted him!
What do you mean they've adopted
him? They adopted him!
They didn't adopt him! What are you talking about?
She said we're never gonna see him again!
The court order says we get him back next week. What are you talking about? All right, relax. We're gonna call Janice.
We have an appointment.
With Judge Shipp?
Yes.
Well, I'm sorry he's not here.
Do you know where he is?
Judge Skinner, can you help these folks?
Yes. I'm Janice Miller. I'm representing Angela and Jerry Cimarelli in the Andrew Taylor custody case.
Oh, yes. Judge Shipp is handling that case. He's away until Monday. Can it wait until then?
No.
In effect, Andrew has been kidnapped.
Kidnapped?
Yes. We think the Taylors may try to escape with him if we delay.
Why don't you try the welfare department?
Where's that?
It's upstairs. Ask for Thomas Hobbs.
Thank you.
Right. Yeah.
Excuse me.
Hi. I'm Tom.
Janice.
I know. Judge Skinner called. Have you got the adoption papers? Right over there. Thank you. Dorothy, would you give me the
The sheriff, please.
Mm-hmm. It's unbelievable what Ray Engler left out of this thing. Like he conveniently left out any mention of you guys having legal custody. According to this, Andrew's been living out here with his grandparents. His mother died of natural causes. And his father is just off somewhere. Did the father give consent to this?
Yeah, I guess they've been planning this for quite a while.
And I knew they were up to something. They were just too calm in court.
Mr. Hobbs, I've got the deputy down the line.
Oh. Joe, it's Tom. Listen, Zach and Jean Taylor. I guess you could say they kidnapped a kid. I know, but I'm sitting here with his legal guardians and their lawyer. Listen, Joe, we have a feeling that the Taylors might try to escape with the kid, and I'd like you to get out there with some men and watch. Right. Okay. That's it. Let's go.
I want to see the document allowing you to do this.
Here, how about this?
Taylor, if you don't open this door, I'm going to shoot this lock off, and you better believe it. No, not you.
Strictness, they're the foster
Mommy.
Parents. Don't you
Hi,
knew?
Sweetie.
No,
we
right. don't know.
It's just a temporary right. measure.
What is temporary? Well, temporary. What is temporary?
The law demands that I stay neutral and that Andrew's welfare is paramount.
So
I'm obligated to hand him over to foster parents until this thing gets straightened
When's
out.
When's that?
Well, that's for a judge to decide. Believe me, the Strickmans are wonderful
going?
People.
No, where are they going? Can I even hold him?
Mrs. Cimarelli, please.
But that's my sister's baby. That's my baby. You don't understand. They lied. They kidnapped him. He doesn't know what's going on. He needs me.
Please.
He doesn't know what's going on.
Mrs. Cimarelli, please. Just until Monday. 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 Listen to me. I promise. I'll get it straightened out.
I sure do miss the old church. And I sure do miss the good people of Marion.
We miss you too, Ken.
Reverend, I need guidance.
Ken, you're being tested. And the Lord won't desert you in your time of need.
Reverend, the longer my son stays with my parents, the stronger our case becomes.
We're organizing pickets. Go into court. Your parents have a lot of friends to marry. Ken, I want you to bow your head. I'd like to offer a prayer for you.
I just keep my son in Indiana. That's my prayer.
Dear Heavenly Father, we beseech your blessings for Ken Taylor.
When Judge Shipp found out the whole story, he was mad at Ray Engler for duping him. But he took it out on Judge Skinner, who withdrew from the case.
So where's Judge Shipp?
Well, he turned around and withdrew himself.
So what does that mean to us?
That's what we're trying to find out now. So just hang in there.
Our intervention's been voided.
Which means what? What?
Andrew goes back to the Taylors.
What?
This is a nightmare!
Just until the trial.
What are you talking about? We don't even have a judge.
They're looking for one.
Someone's been bought off here.
Now, that's not true.
Oh, come on, don't give me... Who the hell do we have to buy off?
Mrs. Cimarelli, you two are both out of line.
Angela, it's not about corruption and bribery. It's become a cause celeb.
Oh, explain that one to me. What does that mean?
It's become a public issue in Indiana. Ah. And we've got to go back to New York and do the same...
Well, and leave Andrew here?
It's the only way. We'll fight fire with fire.
No man is an island. We've all heard that before. But what if we were, each of us alone, floating? Then what do we have? I'll tell you what we have. We have what God has given us. A sea of compassion that touches us all. So when you pray, reach into your hearts, feel, oh, what it must be like for someone to try and steal your grandchildren away. Pray for our brother and sister, the Taylors, that they may win this struggle.
Excuse me, Mrs. Cimarelli?
Mm-hmm.
My name is Peter Moss. I'm a reporter.
Thank you for coming.
Oh, it's my pleasure. You know, it's hard to believe that something like this could happen in America. It's like a state-sanctioned kidnapping.
Yeah, well, it did. And I'll tell you everything.
Wait, before you tell me anything, I want you to know that I'm considering doing an article for the New York Times. So if you're exaggerating any of this, you're going to be sorry you ever met me because I don't like to be used for a publicity gimmick. Understood?
Understood.
All right, talk to me.
Join you?
Yeah, please.
I just talked to that reporter. Well, you must have said something right because he's gonna do a story.
Yeah, Teresa would thank you for all this.
I thought that was who you were thinking about. We're gonna get Andrew back, you know. I hired an Indiana lawyer today to help us, Greg Reed. He's going to handle our affairs down there, but I'll stay in very close touch with him.
I don't know if Jer and I can afford all this.
Don't worry about it.
Janice, why are you doing this?
Frank is my second husband. My first. Well, I got beaten up a lot. Teresa was a battered wife, wasn't she?
She never said.
But you knew.
I thought.
And then I would just push that thought right out of my head. I don't know. I never saw any bruises.
No one did on me either. I just stayed away from people when I was like that. I did that for 9 years. Even in that situation, they don't tell. Not until they're ready. Some don't live long enough.
You're doing this for Teresa.
I'm doing this for me.
Your Honor, this is a farce. My clients are law-abiding citizens of Marion, Grant County, and Indiana. There's nothing illegal here.
Crazy.
These loving grandparents are the only people eligible in the whole country to adopt this child because they have the father's consent.
Quiet.
We will have order. This is not a revival meeting here.
This is scary.
Your Honor, the best interest of the child is at stake. An adoption takes precedence over custody orders.
God bless the Taylors!
Order! Order in this court! It is apparent that this hearing is out of control. However, I've heard enough. I'll make my decision after both attorneys submit briefs.
I will make my decision within the 90 days provided in the statute.
This court is adjourned.
Collect call from Angela. Hey, Pop, how's Ma doing? Oh, good. What about Gina? She being a good girl? Yeah. No, actually, I think it went pretty well. No, we haven't gotten a ruling yet, but I don't think it should be too much longer. Pop, can you hold on a second? What are you looking at? What? Pop, I gotta go. Yeah, don't give up hope. Okay. Bye-bye.
Yeah. Hey, Edge, where are you going?
Can I talk to you? We're leaving tomorrow. So could I just see him before we go?
What time's your flight?
Noon.
9 o'clock, then. We'll give you 10 minutes.
Andrew, sweetie.
Shuma toy.
Look what we got you. Look, you see, sweetie? Look.
He has too many stuffed animals already. He doesn't need any more.
Shh. Let me hold him, please. Come here. Come here.
Do you see the damage you're doing to this child? Don't you see that you're hurting him more by trying to take him away? It'll be all right.
Years Teresa and I spent in this room.
Yeah.
15. She taught me everything. She kept every one of my secrets. She made me feel better when I was sick. She cheered me up when you dumped me. She was always there for me. I just assumed she always would be.
I mean, I thought I'd have time to pay her back. I have left of her is Andrew, and I've lost him.
That's not true.
Please, Jer, I just gotta face it.
No, you don't have to face up to anything.
Yes, I do.
Hey, Angela, you know, you still got two other people in your family besides Andrew. We need you too.
Angela? Oh, excuse me. Peter Moss just called. He wants you to know the story he's written for the New York Times runs this Sunday.
Really?
Yeah.
It's called Janice.
Okay.
I just want Judge Neuwirth to know that he made the New York Times. Yes. The story is featured in this Sunday's magazine section. Well, you might want to tell him that it reports the inexcusable judicial machinations that adversely affect the fate of a child not yet 3 years old. That he's being passed around like a basketball. That's a popular game in Indiana, isn't it? Yes, that's what it says. Thank you. He's in court. I think they hide in there.
Technically, under Indiana law, the Cimarellis do not have to be notified about the adoption. However, the spirit of the Indiana adoption statutes required notice to guardians, courts, or agencies having custody or any other direct contact with a child. I am therefore vacating the Taylor's adoption. I want the child delivered to the Grant County Department of Public Welfare and then to Angela and Jerry Cimarelli on or before noon on Tuesday, April the 14th.
All right, Mommy, be right back with some ice cream. What do you want me to do? I'm getting some ice cream.
Ray Engler's still in court. They're trying to get the order stayed. He said just keep driving around and don't let them find you.
Excuse me, please. No pictures right now. Excuse me, Frank, Jim, please, in the room here.
What's going on?
Not here. Well, I have a statement for you later, please. Jim, Frank, a little bit later. Take the elevator. Excuse me, please. What happened? Sit down. Get out of here.
All right, now.
The appellate court has granted Ray Engler a stay.
Oh, God.
That's it!
Angela.
You told us this was set.
It is set. Now, this is not like it was before. Angela, the hearing is this afternoon. This is Ray Engler's last gasp.
We've come this far.
I'm sorry. I just can't take another setback. I'm going to explode. Really, I will.
Your Honors, as you can see here, the Cimarellis have waited too long to intervene in this adoption. The allotted 60 days has long since elapsed. Further, they were not parties to the adoption in the first place, because matters of custody in New Jersey and adoption in Indiana are separate and entirely different forms of physical possession.
Your position on that point I can only characterize as ridiculous. Stay is denied.
Your Honor, I believe if you'll examine the...
Next case, please.
Really? That's it?
It's yours.
Son, we did everything we could do. We tried... I know... I'm sorry, son.
Kisses.